As we always say, the next NVIDIA is NVIDIA. So people looking for the next Tesla, the next Microsoft, the next Google need to be looking for something else. That's the old Rumsfeld's unknown unknowns. Now, the other NVIDIA is different. So that's a company that might enjoy success from the same AI growth drivers that NVIDIA does. So today we're going to talk about a company that's reminiscent of NVIDIA's AI growth spurt. And we like to refer to that as a skate to where the puck will be situation. So the chart here you see in the upper right, this is from Main Street Data. The dark blue bars represent NVIDIA's data center segment, which now comprises upwards of 80% of total revenues. Now look at their second biggest revenue segment below in the lighter blue bars. That's gaming. You see how that hasn't been growing? So the idea is that the AI segment for NVIDIA is what all the excitement is about, and that for today's company, we're going to see something similar. Now, before we talk about today's company, I wanted to touch on classifying AI revenues. So it's very easy for a company to say, well, our fastest growing segment is AI. And that might make sense. Who cares if it's AI or not? You have a fast growing segment, and that's what investors are after. What doesn't make sense is when they say, well, our AI segment is expected to start growing soon. By now, AI is mature enough that growth should be present. So companies that will say, we're an AI company, great, where's your growth? So an AI company with a growing AI segment isn't useful if total revenues are flat or declining. That's very important. So look at NVIDIA as a great example of that, right? Their one segment, that entire tide lifted the broader company. So when we look at today's stock, Broadcom, we see this article from Morningstar. It says, Broadcom stock climbs as one bull calls it a world-class AI play for cheap, right? So that's, in a nutshell, everything everyone wants to hear. And you see a couple things here. They say, Broadcom impresses analysts with a recent AI event. We're going to take a look at that. And then this research piece that TD Cowen put out, better late than never, implying there's been some sort of run-up for Broadcom. Indeed, there has been. Now, the AI presentation here titled Enabling AI Infrastructure, it's 100 pages of AI banter, and frankly, it's not very accessible to retail investors. Before we talk about that, I wanted to touch on who Broadcom is.
Who?
So here you can see their revenue growth. From 2009 to 2023, we see very strong revenue growth. How are they accomplishing that? That's primarily through acquisitions. So Broadcom has a history of making large acquisitions. They buy companies and they sell companies, kind of like a PE firm, a private equity firm, though they would say they're quite different. They tried to acquire Qualcomm for $130 billion in 2017, but they were denied. That was probably their largest acquisition effort. I think second largest would be VMware, you see, which closed in November of 2023. So it's said, according to Wikipedia, the failure of Broadcom's bid to buy Qualcomm led to Broadcom looking to acquire infrastructure software as an alternative way of growing their size. So they acquired Computer Associates, or CA. They're a longtime giant in software for mainframes. They acquired the enterprise security business of Symantec, and then they spent $61 billion acquiring VMware, which closed late last year. Now, this stock has been performing quite strong over time. They must be very competent in M&A and realizing synergies. Indeed, that's the case. We're going to look at their financials later. They're quite impressive. It's the ninth largest company in the U.S. now. I found that surprising. When we try to figure out what they do, we get down to these two revenue segments, infrastructure software and semiconductor solutions. We break these out using Main Street Data. You see on the top there, that's the semiconductor solutions segment. So not seeing much growth on a quarterly basis there recently. The bottom segment, that big spike, that's VMware. Now, before we start talking about Broadcom and AI, I wanted to ask you to help support us. You don't have to buy anything. We're just happy to help you become a better investor because our goal is to make you want to buy something from us. To all those who give us money watching this video, thank you sincerely. For those who aren't, please sign up to our free newsletter in the comments section. There's a link for it there pinned. Now, let's talk about Broadcom and AI. So you see this slide, broadest and industry-leading AI networking portfolio. Well, you could just cross out AI and it would still hold true. And there's this slide, which frankly, I find to be rather suspect. So they're talking about AI revenue as a percent of that semiconductor solutions segment, okay? And you see that's growing over time in this coming year. 35% of the semiconductor solutions segment is going to come from AI, or $10 billion. This graph can grow like a weed. It doesn't matter unless that segment revenues are doing the same. So if semiconductor solutions is enjoying all this growth from AI, we ought to see that segment growing. And as we looked at before, where's the growth? At least on a quarterly basis here, you could see it's not growing very fast. So this represents what you see here, $28.5 billion in revenues for 2023. We're told 35% of 2024 revenues will be $10 billion, implying about the same size. Well, that's not actually the case, because when we look at 2023 comments, we see that they expect semiconductor to sustain its mid to high single digit revenue growth rate. So that's not overly impressive, under double digits there. But what is spectacular is when you look at the $17.6 billion in free cash flow they had for 2023, and also that it's their 13th consecutive increase in annual dividends. So in another 12 years, hopefully they'll be a champion. Now, when we look at that first bullet point talking about semiconductor mid to high single digit revenue growth, that's going to be more likely $30 to $31 billion. What percentage of that is AI? Doesn't matter. Pick your number. What we're focused on here is the overall growth of the segment, as we said before. That growth should be coming in much stronger. Now, bulls are going to say, well, it's right around the corner. Skate to where the puck will be, right? Bears are going to argue it's just labeling. The answer, well, we'll have to see what happens in 2024. But as you can see here, these are outlined in their financials. You can pull them up rather quickly. Semiconductor Solutions needs to show a whole lot more growth for us to be convinced that they're benefiting from the build out of AI data centers, which they well should be. Now, SiliconANGLE put out a piece here, "The Unplanned Genius of Broadcom's Route to AI Dominance." They say, "In our view, Broadcom, along with NVIDIA, has become one of the top two AI plays in the public market." So is this the other NVIDIA that this presentation referred to? Well, in a nutshell, Broadcom is one of the only companies, this is from SiliconANGLE, other than NVIDIA, that makes chips for both internal connectivity for high-performance AI workloads and silicon for high-speed switching across distances. So when NVIDIA acquired Mellanox, they had a proprietary advantage as a result of that. Now, Broadcom is apparently countering with an open standards salvo. Now, we really like open source solutions. I think it's summed up by Bill Joy, who says, no matter who you are, some of the smartest people work for someone else. So open source works quite well to develop technologies over time. Now, the article from SiliconANGLE goes on to talk about how Broadcom is misunderstood, but sharp investors have picked up on this differentiator. Yeah, that's the Broadcom gentleman speaking there. He talks about the 26 sustainable franchises they have, 9 software, 17 hardware, and says they invest when they decide to make an acquisition or enter a space for at least a decade. Well, one would hope so. And he goes on to say, if a market in 10 years is declining low single digits, it's still exciting for us, provided that they enjoy technology leadership, specifically on hardware. They have to be the leader over that duration. And the example that was given is VMware, who have tons of clients. And what they can then do is invest in R&D and more products and sell more stuff to those clients. This goes back to the piece that we did on Okta. Okta has lots of channels that they can sell into, tons of customers, and that over time they can upsell them. So the AVGO AI thesis is summarized as follows. Without networks for AI, there is no AI. And we're talking, this is the SiliconANGLE folks speaking here, we're talking about internal networks between XPUs and chiplets, which they didn't go into, and scaled networks across switches. Remember, only NVIDIA and Broadcom really play extensively in both those markets, so it's essentially a duopoly. While NVIDIA has the early lead with its proprietary InfiniBand networks, Broadcom is playing that long game with open source standards. Now, just some concluding thoughts here. Broadcom is an impressive company in its own right. Now, labeling things AI and then talking about how much they're growing doesn't seem convincing in this case. We need to see abnormal top-line growth in semiconductor segment. This is a skate to where the puck will be situation, so a couple blowout quarters for the semiconductor segment may prove the validity of this thesis as opposed to the mid to high single-digit growth they're expecting. Do note that the VMware acquisition is going to result in strong 2024 growth. You can see here the company is estimating $50 billion in revenues. That's largely going to represent growth from the VMware acquisition. Now, this diagram here by Spear is rather interesting, and you can see where the AVGO logo is represented under chip design and IP there in the upper right, and also in networking, as you would expect. But there are lots of players in the AI data center value chain. Next up, we're going to take a look at AI data center picks and shovels, a second look, I should say. So make sure to subscribe to our channel. In the meantime, I'm going to leave you with this popular piece on valuing NVIDIA. Is NVIDIA overpriced or undervalued? It all depends on how you torture the data. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this today.